Hello everyone and welcome to Van Tech Corner. This is the Mellanox ConnectX-3 FP Plus adapter, and this adapter is in OCB form factor. So right here I have another PCIe X4 to OCB adapters, and this is how it looks like. Previously we already have a 10 gig OpenWRT routing test lab with the Intel Xeon. And in this video, I want to check it out with the Zimaboard because I want to build a low power consumption OpenWRT router that can use for the SFP Plus and SFP module, for example, the GPON module from my internet service provider. And here I have two models or two versions. This adapter is a dual SFP Plus port, and this one is a single port. Alright, so far I have tested with the Zimaboard and it only support the network adapter with single port like this one. And even if when I connect the two XRP Plus port adapter to the Zimaboard, it will not work. And I have tested it with the OpenWRT snapshot and also the OpenWRT 22 stable release as well as the release candidate version. So now I'm going to show you how I install OpenWRT with the driver or the kernel package pre-installed, and we're going to boot up the system. So for the test, I also have a small HDMI monitor right here, and it is being powered by another separate power adapter, so it will not consume the power from the Zimaboard. And I also have a power meter right here so that I can see what is the power consumption of the Zimaboard when the network adapter is connected. Alright, so now let's connect everything and we are ready for the test. Okay, so usually this is how the OCP adapter connected to the network adapter. Alright, and that's it. You just need to tighten the screw right here. Let's insert the Mellanox ConnectX-3 to the Zimaboard. Very good. And now I will need to tighten the screw. And as you can see right here, I have a DAC cable. It is also from Mellanox, and this one is connected to my PC. So now let's go back to the computers and we are going to install OpenWRT on the USB right before we can boot up the system. Alright, so initially I want to have a test like this where the Zimaboard is having the Mellanox ConnectX-3 with two SFP Plus port and is going to have a 1-2 line throughput test, but unfortunately right now only a single port SFP it works on this motherboard, so I'm going to test just the connection from the Zimaboard to my PC and not this one. Alright, so let's go to firmware selector.openwrt.org and get the stable release. So this is 22.03.2 and for sure it will be x86-64, and I'm going to customize the install package. So right here we don't have LuCI and we will need to add the LuCI package, and then we will need the kmod mlx4 core. So this is the support for Mellanox ConnectX-3 series. All right because I already test with the snapshot one, so for this video I will just trying the stable release. And before proceed with the build, I want to add htop as well as bmon so that we can see what is going on. Request build and let's wait for it. The firmware is ready and let's download it. So it's going to take some time. Okay, very good. So this is the firmware that we have generated. And now I'm going to use the Rufus application. Select the firmware. Hit open. and then let's write it to the USB. Make sure you select the correct device. Refreshing partition layout. This may take a while. Alright? No worry, I'm okay with that. Everything is ready and now we can remove the USB, right? And we can back to the Zimaboard. Okay, so on the Zimaboard, we have the HDMI monitors. And now let's connect the USB, right, to the Zimaboard. So right here, I have a USB receiver. It is very small. So this one will be used for the mouse. So now I'm going to connect the Mellanox cable, the DAC cable, to the XFP Plus port. And to be sure, I will connect another Ethernet cable also from my PC to the Zimaboard. Very good. Now let's power on the Zimaboard. Alright, we can see that the power consumption immediately go to 9.6 watt, and we have something going on in the monitors. And OpenWRT is loading. I can hear the fan spinning on the Mellanox ConnectX-3, and it should be up and running. We have the orange LED blinking, and let's see. Alright, so from the log, we can see the MLX4 core update right here, which means the adapter is up and running. And we also have some logs on the Realtek Ethernet adapter. And I can also see that the port is up and running. Alright, it looks like we are ready. And now let's have a little check. So let's run IP link. I'm not sure if it is too small for you, but let's have a quick check first. So we have Ethernet 0, Ethernet 1, and Ethernet 2. And if we take a look at the MAC address, we have the Ethernet 0 starting with E41D, and the rest, Ethernet 1 and Ethernet 2, start with 00E0. So I assume that Ethernet 1 and 2 will be the onboard network adapter. Okay, why this one, Ethernet 0, is the XFP Plus port. Let me zoom it in a little bit so that you can see what is going on. So you can see that Ethernet 0 is having a MAC address of E41D2D, and then Ethernet 1 and 2 is having 00E0. Alright, so Ethernet 1 and 2. Alright, so now we can back to the PC. And let's proceed further. So let's go to the network connection, and we can see that the Mellanox is up and running with an IP address. And on my D-Link, I can see that the status is unidentified because we have yet to configure it, right? So let's go to 192.168.1.1. There is no password by default. That is fine. Let's go to network and interfaces. And right here we have Ethernet 0, Ethernet 1, and Ethernet 2, like what I just said. And the E41D should be the Mellanox connect. Okay. So this one is in the LAN bridge. And Ethernet 1, is it the one port? Alright. So unfortunately the port doesn't come up. So I assume that this port is actually the Ethernet 1 and this one is Ethernet 2. So now I'm going to connect the network cable from my upstream router, which is this yellow cable, to this one. Alright, so let me show you how it looks like. So this one, I assume it is Ethernet 2, 1 and 0. Very good, let's go back to LuCI, and now I'm going to change the Ethernet 1, the one interface, to Ethernet 2. Save, and then the 1.6 as well. Alright, so I can see that the port is up and running, and we have an IP address. So Let's go to system and shopware, and actually right now I just forget to install the iPub tree package. So let's do that together. Is this ready? Yep. Let's install iPub tree. Install. Very good. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the iPub tree server. It's running right now on the Zimaboard, and I'm going to have another connection to my PC. Let's go to the iPub tree directory and then run the iPub tree c192.168.1.1 and then t20. So this will be the test between the Zimaboard and the PC. So basically it is a LAN-to-LAN test, and we're just to test out the throughput of the network adapter. So very good, we are running at 7.7 gigabit per second from the Zimaboard to my PC. And I can see that the power consumption right now is 11.7 watt. So now let's run the same test, but I will show the result from the camera. All right, so we are reaching 10.4. And right here, we can see the actual throughput on the B-mount monitor. All right, so now let's run the test in revert mode. Running the test in revert mode, we got 8.15 gigabit per second. And the power consumption right now is 10.3 watt. All right, so this is the test with the default MTU, and now let's change the MTU and see if there are any changes. So click on the config button and it will show the advanced option for the jumbo packets. It is 1514, but let's try to put it 9000. Hit save. And all right, we have a disconnection, but never mind. Let's see if we can run the test. All right, so for this network adapter, when I change the jumbo frame to 9000, I can see that the throughput go down to 4.77 gigabit per second, which means this is not always a good option to change the Mellanox ConnectX MTU. Let's revert the change and let's proceed with the default one. So we have did a test between the Zimaboard and my PC, which is running Windows, and later on, before ending the video, I will have a test with Ubuntu so that we can see if they the higher throughput. And now I'm going to remove the DAC cable from my PC, and we're going to test it out with a 1 gigabit connection. So during idle, the power consumption is 7.8 watt. And let's see what is the power consumption if I remove this cable. So right after I remove the DAC cable, it changed to 7 watt. Alright, so we have a kernel panel and OpenWRT router is now restarting. So right here I have a fiber cable, as you can see, and this should be the LC connector. It is connected to an SFP module. So this is a very typical and cheap SFP module, and it is 1 gigabit. So now let's connect it to the device. You can see that the BRLAN Ethernet 0 is up and running, and the orange LED is also blinking, which means The Mellanox ConnectX-3 XRP Plus adapter is also supporting 1 gigabit fiber connection via a normal XRP module. Alright, so that is a very good result to see. And now, before ending the video, I will have a quick test with Ubuntu so that we can see the actual throughput between the Zimaboard to the Mellanox ConnectX-3 to my PC via this DAC, via the 10 gig cable. Alright, so let me switch the connection and we're going to have a quick test. So we're back to Ubuntu, and right now the Mellanox Ethernet is up and running. We can see that the link speed is 10 gigabit or 10,000 megabit per second. Alright, that is good. So now let's open the Ethernet connection to the router. And let's start the IPUB 3 test server. Very good, let's open another terminal, new window, and now let's run IPUB 3. I'm not sure if it is installed, but let's give it a try. T20. Alright, so running the test on Ubuntu, I can see that the throughput is also way higher. We are running at 8.63 gigabit per second. This is a really good result to see. And this is with the default setting, there are no touchings on the MTU or anything. And now let's run the test in reverse mode. Running the test in reverse mode, I have a 9.4 gigabit per second throughput. This is a really good result. So we got a stable throughput of 9.4 gigabit per second with 10.6 watt of power consumption. Alright, so I'm going to end the video here, and I have noticed that the Zimaboard doesn't support dual XRP plus configuration. That's why I have yet to test it. But if you have any successful chance to check it out, please share in the comment section. So that's all for this video, and I will see you all in the next one. Thanks for watching and see you.